All right, folks, riddle me this. Who helped light up the world but didn't get nearly enough credit? No, not your grandma with her 500 candles on her birthday cake. I'm talking about Lewis Howard Latimer, the genius who made Thomas Edison and Alexander Graham Bell look good. This man was out here making moves while history was over here acting like he was just the sidekick. Let's set the record straight. So let's take it back, way back to 1848, when baby Lewis popped into the world in Chelsea, Massachusetts. Now, his parents weren't just any parents. They were literal freedom fighters. His dad, George Latimer, escaped from slavery in Virginia, got caught in Boston, and was like, oh no, they got me. But then Frederick Douglass and William Lloyd Garrison stepped in like the original legal dream team, and boom, George bought his freedom. Talk about VIP connections. Now, fast forward to 1864, Lewis at 16 decides he had enough of the struggle and straight up lies about his age to join the Navy. I mean, imagine a teenager today trying to fake their age, but instead of sneaking into a movie, he's sneaking into a war. Different levels of commitment, my friends. When he gets out, he lands this job at a patent law office as basically the office gopher. But Lewis was like, nah, I'm built different. Instead of just fetching coffee, he starts watching the draftsmen like a hawk. One day they blinked and boom, he's out here drawing like a whole architect. So what happens? The bosses are like, yo, my guy, you want to be a draftsman? And that's how you finesse a glow up, people. And just when you think it couldn't get cooler, Lewis gets pulled into two of the biggest inventions ever, telephones and light bulbs. He worked with Alexander Graham Bell to draft the patent for the telephone, meaning Bell had the idea, but Lewis made sure nobody stole it. That's like your best friend coming up with a genius business idea, and you're the one who locks down the paperwork so some dude named Chad doesn't run off with it. And then he links up with Edison. Now, people love hyping up Edison, but let's be real, without Lewis, Edison's light bulbs would have been more like dim bulbs. Lewis figured out how to make them last longer, so instead of burning out in 10 minutes, they could shine for hours. That's like upgrading your phone battery from dies after watching one video to survives a whole road trip. And Lewis just wasn't about science. This man had range. He played the flute, wrote poetry, taught immigrants English and mechanical drawing, and was out here helping Civil War veterans. So, next time you flip a switch or call your bestie, remember that Lewis Howard Latimer was out here doing the work. But did he get statues? Did he get a billion-dollar company named after him? Nope. And that is where we're giving him his flowers today. Drop a comment if you think history needs to put some respect on Lewis's name. And don't forget to like, subscribe, and turn on those notifications, because trust me, we've got more hidden legends to bring to the spotlight. Stay lit, literally.